Hello everyone, this is Tormuse, and I'm picking up where I left off in my Subnautica hardcore game. Yeah. Once again, still, I've run out of leads. Don't know where to look, don't know where to go. Last episode, I was just going around putting down scanner rooms and seeing what I could scan, and it seemed like a decent enough strategy. Like I uncovered that little facility for all the good it did. I kind of feel like a lot of this game is like that. You find something interesting, and it's like, oh, this is something that's going to progress the story or something, and it's just this little dead end thing, which adds a little backstory, I guess, but it doesn't feel like it advances things. Like even finding the infection control facility, I expected that to be huge. I guess it did get the report about the Leviathan egg facility at 1.4 kilometers depth. So there's that, but yeah, a lot of these. I don't know. I feel like following the Torghals, on the Degassi, bore more fruit in terms of advancing things. But I don't know. Anyway, it seems like my best bet for advancing the story is finding more alien facilities, but so it's really unfortunate that the scanner can't detect them. Pretty disappointed about that. It means a lot more manual searching, I guess. I think I need to bring an extra beacon along to I'm just thinking ahead, like since I can't I don't know. Maybe every time I see a warper, I should plunk a beacon down and say, like, warper spotted here, so I know to search that area or something. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Like in the previous game, that lava filled area was like chock full of warpers end to end. I mean, and there was a facility at the bottom of it, but it that in itself shows that they're they can be like really far away from the alien facility that they're guarding, that they're supposedly guarding. So, I don't know. We'll see. Okay, I think I'm ready to go, unless I miscalculated. Hopefully, I didn't. Time will tell. So I figure I'm gonna go to each beacon in turn, and look at that. The little drones are still there. Anyway, I'm gonna go to each beacon in turn and plunk down a scanner room next to it and see what we can detect. So I'm gonna start with the first one. I'm gonna start at the very beginning, a very good place to start. I packed everything that I need for, what's this? Oh, okay, I think I know where I am. It's just so... It's so weird that the, my starting location is different. It throws me off. Like, nothing's where I expect it to be. This is, a little less than 800 meters away from my starting location, so... Should have a decent chunk of territory to scan. All right, here we are, and I'm gonna pull out all my. Stop doing that. Go into storage when I want the. Oh, whoops. I'll come back for the scan room upgrades. Yeah, keep going into storage when I want the get in the paw, and go in the paw when I want to get into storage. That's just, I see how it is. Anyway. Okay. Scan room, go! Hello. And do I have enough? No, I put the titanium on the other side. I just pulled it all out. Okay. And a multi-purpose room, go! Right there. It's connected, right? Yeah. And hatch. Right there. There we go.
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Interior modules. Oh wait, no, it's interior pieces. Did I misjudge the titanium I need? Ah, darn it. Is there a piece of titanium I can grab around here? I calculated out the titanium I needed for the scanner room, multipurpose room, and hatch, it seems, but not the bioreactor itself. Should I go back for more titanium, or should I see if I can luck into grabbing some here? There's one. Something to scan? Well, there's a wreck here, so... Oh, hey. You know what? I think this might be... This might be... the wreck that I found by chance in the, that previous game, where... Come on, cut. There you go. I think this might be the wreck that I found in the previous game, where, which had, Bart Turgall's, PDA, like the talk about him and stuff. Like, I mean, not. Yeah, this looks like it. Hey!
Integrating new PDA data.
And there's the titanium I need. Hooray! So that worked out well. It's like the universe wanted me to find this. I happened upon it by chance. You know, in two different ways, in two different games. I think it's all that's in there. I do all this work to cut into it, and then there's like, oh, there's just a path in there. That's how it goes. But yeah, this is part of the Altera rescue mission. Wait, that's back home. This is where I want to go. Part of the Altera rescue mission, they had a little outline talking about the Turgals. Oh wait, before I go in here, I need to grab the biofuel. Did I put it on the other side? I think I did. It's okay, I have enough inventory space to grab the little Ming plant that I put. Would you quit it? Didn't mean for this to stick this far out. Okay, just put this bit of copper away. Anyway. Just whip out the habitat builder. Before I do that, I don't know if it makes a difference if I'm going to put the upgrades in first before building the bioreactor. Just in case that it affects. Wait. Want to face it a different direction? Let's quit it. I'm rapidly dying from oxygen loss. There you go. Want the entry point facing me. And then feed that into the bioreactor. It's alive!
Power restored. All primary systems online.
Okay, so nothing obvious from the topographical map here. Like, the previous episode, there was that big rectangular thing. Hey, and somebody's already stolen the drone. You silly stalkers. Anyway. Okay, so search for data boxes first. Excellent, that's what I'm here for. Those stalkerfish wasted no time in stealing my drones. Silly stalkers. So that's, these are out of order. What's up with that? Anyway, it would be number 3 and 4. Let's just, these are the ones from the yesterday's abandoned thing. And, yeah, let's check out this. I already read it yesterday. yeah, it's interesting. So yeah, Bartragal, son of Paltagal, he's the vice president. You know, nepotism isn't dead. He was 19 when he disappeared, so that initially made me go, oh hey, he's some kind of science prodigy. Like he was all sciencing it up for when they got stuck here. But he also had enhanced learning techniques and cerebral implants, so he's like, yeah, he's a cyborg basically. And Emissary Kassar's name comes up again, so it said this in the other reports too. Like the fact that it says Kassar reports what they were doing on their mission really highlights the fact that. You know, Paul and Bart, they just went out on their own. They didn't tell anyone where they were going. Like, you know, kind of reckless like that. Just the two of them plus their mercenary they hired. Basically he didn't tell anyone except his close friend, Emissary Kassar. Yeah. He was going to be made Chief Operating Officer. It's making that noise. Anyway, let's go find this data box. It looks like there's just one. Right? No, there are two. There are two little red dots. There's one below me, and there's one way the heck over here. Let's drink some water. And let's go! I guess we'll get the closer one first. Ah, okay. Closer one. Would be the one in the pod itself, which, oh wow, this strut just went right down the middle of it. I already got this data box, right? Like, this would have been, like, the first thing I got. Yeah, it's already open. I didn't miss anything in here, and there's, like, little stalkers playing with the drones. Wait, I want to see. Ooh, he's infected. Oh, well, he needs, you know, he needs palliative care because he's infected, so like let him have his play. This is you know, this is just part of his palliative care, making sure his last moments are as fun as possible. And I'll just scan this for the heck of it, I guess. Anyway, let's get back into the Ephleviathans. Get in there. Like, oh, now you don't want to get in. You're just going to collide with it without getting in it? Anyway. This way. Yeah, that's the wreck that I just explored. Is that, yeah, there's a little fragment on top. I don't want to fill up on, I don't want to fill up my inventory right away. Let's, like, try to save that. What ho? Another wreck. Could this be a wreck I've explored before? Possibly, maybe. Or maybe it isn't. Maybe I haven't been here before. Well, let's find out. Let's also pull out the Thermoblade just in case. I really need to get in the habit of getting stuff like that ready ahead of time. Like, okay, so here's the entry point. I'm just going to take Gander around the side anyway. Just, sometimes, well, often they have multiple entry points. Yeah, that's what I thought. That data box there is, this is the one with the dramatic music. I'm just going to open this and confirm that, though. This is where the data box that had the ultra-high capacity oxygen tank to the left, right here. There it is. Yep. The game just keeps bringing me back to this. Okay. Well, okay, that's been thoroughly searched. It's thoroughly searched multiple times, even. I'm gonna resist the urge to scan everything. I should at least take a look. That is a bioreactor, right? It's like, and this is also bioreactor. Yeah, okay. Like, there's nothing here that's new. What are you doing here? There you go. You just sleep that off. Okay, so, yeah, back to the scanner room. But yeah, I was gonna say, like, need to stay in the habit of getting those things ready in when I'm safe, because those stalkers, they like to make so much noise. Yeah, because like reflecting on
warning, emergency power only, oxygen production offline.
Like in that previous episode where just grab a random fish. No, I'll just use up the things I'm carrying. Oh wait. Okay, there's a random fish I can grab. Just throw it into the scanner. I mean, into the bioreactor, which powers the scanner. What was I saying? Yeah, the previous episode, like, with that sea dragon and so on, the fact that I had my stasis rifle ready and my sea glide charged, that saved my life. Like, I would not have survived without that that ready. Okay, next, scan for fragments, because I believe this is supposed to detect only fragments that I haven't scanned before. And is that part of the... Okay, so there are two way over here. I don't see them, though. I don't see them highlighting. There they are. So just those two little red dots, that's it? Okay. So I'll check those out next. And then after that, I'll scan for wrecks. See if there are any more wrecks that I haven't seen or explored. That goes pretty deep. And it even has a little femoral at the bottom. Okay, I'm just gonna take a peek. There's probably okay. Yeah, there's probably yeah, if I wanted to make a base that made use of the thermal plants, it'd be a good place for it. I have no idea what the range of the range extenders is. I'm just curious about that space around the thing. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna hop in the F Leviathans just so I can better assess how warm it is there. I don't want to swim right into the fire or anything. Yeah, like even when it's going whoosh, blah, flames, it's 53 degrees, and the suit is protected up to 70 degrees, so I'm okay. Huh. So that's 63 degrees, I'm fine. Where am I? Where is this? Okay, so this just leads out again. Oh hey, there are more fragments. Although I have a sneaking suspicion those might be the fragments that I was looking at before, the ones that are like underground somehow. Maybe I should. Okay, yeah, I had a feeling this is where I was. Yeah, I remember this cave. I remember exploring this in the previous game, in the previous season. Okay, curiosity satisfied. Didn't realize there was a way up here. Like, it leads right to the surface. Huh. I think these are just dead ends here. For 6 degrees, I'll hop out. Yeah, it's just dead end. Just whatever. Okay, anyway, you know, I'm just curious. Okay, I'll turn it around now. So, there were two fragments, and now I see more than two, so... Are those the same... Silly stalkers. You know, I use those cameras to mark the location of the base so I know where to go. Like, I use those to point me in the right direction. Oh well. Yeah, I have a feeling these fragments here might be the underground ones that I, for the life of me, couldn't figure out how to get to. Which might be there as bugs and they're inaccessible. Although, like, looking at this, like this one right here, for instance, this is clearly right in the surface, right? It's not, like, it, by all appearances, it looks like it's inside this crate right here, but it isn't. It's not scannable or anything. But yeah, some of the others like this, like, I'm moving over it to get an idea where it is. Like, yeah, that's clearly, like, it is just under the surface. Like, seriously, I'm seriously tempted to walk the prawn over this area to see if I can get it to fall through, just so I can see if that there's anything there. Like, they're above me here, but this doesn't go anywhere. Like, my first thought is, oh, maybe it's part of this cave system, but nope, this cave system doesn't go anywhere. It just ends. Oh! I found a spot where I'm clipping through it. Can I find another spot like that where I can, like, partially clip through the wall and see what's there? Maybe I should get a running start so that it does its thing where it bugs out and doesn't render properly, and I can just pass right through the floor. Let's get this right. Ooh, very close to the aura. I know, like, I keep seeing these and think, is there something important I'm missing here? Because these keep coming up. I don't know. Like, it could be that these are, like, totally nothing, that I'm totally wasting my time with them, because I have seen fragments show up, and it was like, you know, beacon fragments are just like, I already got these a long time ago. So it's like, why is it showing them? So I don't know. What about over here? Can I partially clip through the wall here, and if I hit it at the right angle, maybe? Oh. There's nothing there. There actually is nothing there. Here I am clipping through the wall so I can see better. I can see the fragment clear as day, and there's nothing there. You know what? F it, I give up. Here, I don't think there's anything here. Eat another fish. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna stun him. And then eat him. No. Oh, hello. That stalker just got a lifelong lesson in don't mess with the crash fish. Anyway. Where is that scanner room again? Okay, so there are cameras 5 and 6, and the scanner room itself should be near them. I can see it, fortunately. I can see the scanner room itself. So I'm gonna tell it to search for Rex. Oh right, there's no. It still has power. 144 power. It drew that from a single peeper. It's not just high calorie and input. Like, they've got. It just proves a lot of energy for this thing too. Like, seriously, I just put a single peeper in, and that's how much power generated. Okay, so I see one red dot, I see two red dots. One dot, red, two dot, red. I was gonna try to do the Dr. Seuss rhyme. One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish. Okay, so, like, right away, it should detect the pod underneath my feet. Little drones again. Four wrecks. So, yeah, so there's the pod right under my feet. This is the pod that I'm just looking at. It's nighttime, which is a little annoying. Sorry, I turned around because this my view reoriented itself to the sea lot. Oh, okay. So there are two of them over here. One of these is the one that I was just looking at. Oh, wait. No, this is the one I was just looking at. And there are two more besides that? Okay. And another one? Oh, wow. Wrecks everywhere, it seems. I mean, there are no data boxes or fragments amongst them, but maybe there'll be a PDA. So they're still worth looking. Like, if I can find something which gives me a lead, that'd be amazing. But I think this is where the tiger plant is, yeah. Yeah, like, I've been to this wreck before. Like, I recognize it. So it's probably not worth... It's probably a total waste of my time to, Wait, is this... This actually is the It is the same way. And the door auto-closed itself again. Wait, okay, so if this is that wreck, then what was the other wreck that I saw? Okay, my server itself turned around. This is... mixing up which wreck is which. Anyway. So the one... Oh, great. Again, these little orange circles, they don't have distances associated with them. So, like, they're the same size no matter how distant you are, so it's hard to gauge which one is which. Life pod number 6. I was considering flunking down into the scanner room here as well, but, maybe there's, you know, no need, because, That's, okay, that's 100 meters away. I mean, it might be worth pulling down the scanner room anyway. I don't think it's gonna uncover any new wrecks, though. I don't know. I said I was going to go to each of the beacons in turn. Maybe that's a bit much. Maybe going to each pod is a bit much. Now what have we here? Bioreactor fragment. Whee! I don't know why that amuses me. And that's just metal salvage, yeah, that's what I figured. Yeah, I mean, it didn't detect data boxes or fragments, so it's like the only thing I might find here is abandoned PDA. Oh, right, emergency power. It finally ran out of power. That's how long it took the peeper to exhaust the energy. Ooh, tiger plant, it's shooting stuff at me. Oh, those things are so annoying. They'd be less annoying if the stasis rifle worked on them and made them, you know, like if it made them, like you can hit them with the stasis field, but it doesn't stop them from shooting spikes at you. Like, I would love to just, you know, fire off a stasis field, put it to sleep so it doesn't bug me while I search and do stuff. Yeah, so a quick survey of this wreck tells me that like there's nothing here. In fact, I think that's one that I've seen before. Okay, so that's back where I came. So these are the remaining wrecks that I haven't looked at. Sorry. Now, the one that's between the drones, that'll be the escape pod itself. And I believe... just want to get visual confirmation of that. I believe the one... oh, great. The one that I was just looking at to the right here, that'll be one of the ones that I was just... that I looked at. So, gosh darn it. Which was... hold on. Which was the one that I just saw on the left? Over here. Is it this one? I guess so. I see a little grav trap fragment there. Okay, I don't think there's anything of interest here. I mean, hey, I found the wreck with the Bart Torgals thing. Although I found that before I even built, before I got the scanner room going, so... well, I mean, it worked out, I guess, but, oh, sorry. Whatever. Anyway, let's pack up and move on. I don't think there's anything else to be found here. I mean, like, should I put one over pod 6? It's pretty close. I don't think it would cover a significant area. No, I think... oh yeah, I should drink some water. Yeah, I think I should move on.
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Should I scan one more time? Just grab a random fish to throw in there. I'm tempted to grab a, you know what, I'm gonna throw in a seed cluster. I'm just curious. I wonder if like animals give more energy than plants do. Like, despite the size difference, like. Like, you look at something like this and you go, oh, it's huge, it's gonna give it power for a long time. But that peeper was so, you know, was so filling, so to speak, that it makes me wonder about that. Maybe, you know, maybe it's something specific to peepers. I'm just for the heck of it, just gonna... those silly stalkers. It's probably totally... I shouldn't waste my time with this. It's probably totally futile to try to find the stalker tooth. Because experience tells me it sank through the floor a while ago. And there's no chance of finding it. Yeah, you have to grab those when they first fall out. Because... it does. They.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
They do not take long to get lost. Completely. Okay. Skyrim upgrades removed. You know, I would like it if when I'm coming out of the inventory screen. And I push a number key, it switches that number already. I have to wait for it. Okay, if I come out of inventory and push 4 right now, it pulls up the scanner and then pulls up the habitat builder. Like, it's designed to pull out the tool that you just had. And I have to wait for that animation. I have to wait for him to finish the animation of putting a PDA away, and then do the animation for pulling out the habitat builder, and then push four, so to pull out the scanner. You know, like it feels clunky, and there's no need for it. It's just that's just an issue I have with the interface in this. Anyway, let's take apart the scanner room. And let's take apart the multi-purpose room. And there you go, about everything. Packed up, ready to go, except the drones. Which is, the stalkers are still playing with them. Yeah, look at them. Look at this silly stalker. And you know, and from what I've observed of the school of stalkers following him, from what I've observed of the stalkers, like it seems that each of them has their own, I don't know, nest or territory or something, because I've noticed each individual stalker has its own place where it drops its metal. And, like, another one of those stalkers is going to pick it up and take it. Yeah, see? This is the infected one again. That's a different stalker carrying it. And they don't take them randomly. Well, I mean, I guess there's probably their nesting point is generated randomly. But each one has its own specific spot, which is its home. They all love the metal so much. Look at them all following it. Just you wait. As soon as he drops it, one of them's going to pick it up and carry it somewhere else. And he's going to take it over to his own nest. Something just bumped into me. I wasn't moving. Silly stalker. Anyway. Okay. That's enough of that. Let's move on. Yeah, I guess pod 6 is, like, so close. This one's a kilometer away. This one's here where Emissary Kassar crashed. You know, the Targal's family friend. And also apparently a very religious man. You know, it's the title Emissary. Kind of wonder if that's a vague allusion to Deep Space Nine, actually. Because, the main character of that show, Star Trek Deep Space Nine, Benjamin Sisko, Commander Benjamin Sisko, the main character, is hailed as the emissary of the prophets. He's seen as this important religious figure, even though he doesn't want to be, because he's not a religious man. that's just a kind of a one of many plot points of that show. anyway, because he was the first one to discover the mysterious aliens living inside the wormhole that these strange creatures that live outside of linear time. That's another thing. Anyway. But yeah. Sorry, what's that? So that's just that strange formation there just caught my eye, and I just wondered. Oh, okay. Don't think I've seen a Cyclops hull fragment that looked like that before. Is that the power transmitter there? Huh. That's right next to it. Did I just miss that when I was searching here, or did I already have it at that point? Anyway, let's build this thing. Scanner room. Let's hope I find something of interest here. As I mentioned, maybe I didn't mention it. I don't know. I just got up from sleep. I actually got to bed at a decent hour. I got to bed at 11 p.m. How about that? Not like 3 a.m. or 6 a.m. or 9 a.m. My sleep schedule's been all over the place lately, but it's like, hey, I actually went to bed at night and got up in the morning this time. How about that? And I just kind of launched straight into this. I haven't eaten breakfast yet, so I'm gonna have to. Come on. Just want a quick meal before I continue this. Now there are no stalker fish here to carry my stuff away. That. And that and that, and I'll take these along too, and oops, I need one more, I think. Because I need 2 titanium for the hatch, and 3 titanium for the bioreactor. I did it again, see?
Emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
I should have grabbed another fish. Oh well. So yeah. Emissary Kassar. Like, apparently a religious person and, like the world building in this, like the just grab him. Like his final his parody of the Lord's Prayer kind of thing. Kind of sounds like this is neat. Oh, it's that structure there. I don't know. Just kind of reminds me of. It looks like somebody with his arms in the air or something. Like, is he shrugging or is he just? Or is he? I don't know. Like, speaking of religious figures, maybe it's. That's interesting. I feel like checking that out. And hey, there's a data box nearby. And a wreck. Well, there has to be a wreck, because this will at least detect Kassar's pod. This is all sloped. And, I know that nearby is that underwater alien portal. I know it's nearby, and the fact that I can't see it is a little troubling, because that means, if I can't find it when I know it's there, okay, there you go. That's it there. But yeah, if I can't find things like that when I know they're there, then, like, how can I expect to find them if I don't know they're there? Yeah, I'm gonna have to, like, do this kind of whole thing and, like, carefully circle around every topographical map for this search here, because, that's something that could easily have been missed. But, I'm pretty sure that's the one that I already found. So if it's there, like if I head in a southerly direction, I should find it. But before I do that, let's see, searching for st- data box. Oh, there it is. Way over there. Water, right. That's what I was looking for. Searching at night, which is never fun, but whatever. Okay. Okay, I'm just really, I'm curious about this thing now. This is that mess. What the heck made that noise? Is that a bone shark? That's a freaking bone. Screw you. Bone shark jerk. Just trying to explore over here. Whoa, why is the data box elevated? Is this where the terrain starts sloping? Like, am I gonna find a wreck on top of the hill or something? Okay, I'm looking up. I'm not seeing the data box anymore. Hold on. Did I like go past it? Okay, so the camera's like 400 meters away. And it has, the scanner has a range of 500 meters. Let's patch up the damage to this thing.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay, seriously though, this is me looking up. You can see the surface there. Scan room is there, 40 meters away. Don't spin like that, please. Ugh. Now I'm all turned around. Lovely. Seriously though, back up. Where was the data box? It was above me. This I get the definite feeling the scan room is bugging out again. Okay, there it is. Oh! The wreck is above me, and I did go past it. It is just, it was in one of the trees. Or one of the, you know, one of the fungal trees. Okay, I'm gonna disable cameras 5 and 6. Because this is silly. Just, I don't wanna see them again. They're just distracting. Now this is interesting. What are the chances of a big chunk of the aurora landing on top of one of these fungal growths here? Like, I'm just imagining, you know, from the game design perspective, someone's a little creative in their placement of wrecks here. Okay, this might require a Pathfinder tool, depending how extensive this is. Now let's take a look around the first room at least. I mean, maybe I should be pulling out the Pathfinder tool automatically in these circumstances before I do anything. Like, maybe that's something I need to get in the habit of doing. Yeah, what the hell? Okay, well, let's take a look this way first, I guess. Where is the data box? There. It looks like it might be. Do I have to cut my way through this? No. maybe it's accessible from the other side. Okay, this is a quick dead end. Curiously, there are no fragments here. Oh, okay. Well, there was a propulsion can fragment. I'll grab it, I guess. You know, this is the kind of thing, like, I intend to search for a while, so I don't want to, like, completely fill up my inventory with, you know, basic things like titanium. Oh, and I just got stuck on something. And that's alarming. That's increasingly alarming. Get me out of here, thank you. Shh. Don't do that, like, don't make me panic. Panic is when I make mistakes. Like, I still had plenty of oxygen, so there wasn't reason to get really scared yet, but it's like no, don't do this to me. Like, no. Anyway. Right, so I went that way already, as evidenced by the presence of the the Pathfinder node there. Is there a way through here? Oh, okay. How do I get there? Like, it looks like there's a path through here, and this door isn't openable, though. It is just a feature on the wall, basically. This panel's busted up. Like, can I go behind it somehow? Maybe. Is there a way through here? Is this going to be another case of an inaccessible data box? It's daytime now. Like, I hope not. Like, that's a propulsion can fragment, I can tell. Like, this thing's up in the trees. It's special. There's gotta be a way there, right? Excuse me. Could this be an alternate entrance which leads to another part of the wreck? Perhaps? Maybe? Oh? You know, like, I don't think I've actually seen a wreck that's compartmentalized like this before, where there are two completely separate entry points which lead to completely separate parts of the wreck. So that's cool. Yeah, and that other compartment had nothing but a single... There was a single propulsion cannon fragment. So this is more interesting. I have to cut my way in. Oh, don't tell me this leads back. Oh. I swear I saw the scanner signals. Did I see the scanner symbol flash on the screen there, or? Well, this looks familiar. I guess the Aurora is probably, I was gonna say that the Aurora was probably built to be, what's the word? Modular. So they probably have ka-chunk rooms plunked down, which are, you know, each section where the room is identical. That doesn't explain why the debris fell down in an identical manner, though. And here's the same unopenable door, even though it looks like it should be openable. What the frig? What, those things do damage you? Are you freaking kidding me? In all the games I played, I've never had one of those things shock me before. Anyway, let's get an oxygen refresh. I've never had one of those things shock me before. That was kind of weird. Huh. Let's give you a top up. And get a thermoblade ready, I guess. I don't really expect to use a thermoblade in here. A pathfinder tool will probably be more apt. Okay, anyway, where is the data box with respect to this room? Aha! A door. Maybe an openable door. Come on, please let there be something in here. Like, this is, you know, risk reward thing. This is very secret. Cyclops thermal reactor module. Okay. Converts environmental heat energy into electrical power for use by the Cyclops. You know. Considering how energy inefficient the Cyclops is, not bad. Being able to recharge out in the field. That's kind of cool. Hey, look. There's an advanced PDA. Aurora scanner room voice log. Huh. Yeah, I was gonna say, like, I mean, scanner room voice log. That's one of those things. It could go either way. It could be meaningless fluff, just, you know, just sort of background. What am I trying to say? Just flavor text, or it could be somebody giving an important piece of information. Employing mirrors of power only. That, again, that peeper charged it for a while.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay. Let's see what's in this voice log. Commander Keen.
The way I see it, no one's to blame here.
He gave me the wrong coordinates.
She didn't give me clear instructions. Okay, I'll rephrase. You've been equally incompetent. Now, we've lost time, but we're closer to the planet. So if the Degassi's out there, the scan should pick it up.
Why are we even helping the Mongolians? They're the competition.
Enjoy your shore leave on Sanjay Station? Like having fuel in the tanks? Thank the Mongolians. We run the scans, we show them we didn't find anything, and we say thanks for the free dinner. Clear? Sir, there's something odd on the surface scan here. Turn that recorder off.
Uh-oh. Turn that recorder off. Something odd on the surface scan. Presumably he's referring to the alien structure or something. Did Commander Keen spot the alien structure before it shot him down? But yeah, they're looking for the Degassi. They're looking for the Turgals and all that. That's pretty well established by this point. Okay, anyway. Let's head back. Oh, it's daytime. Yeah, I want to take a look at this structure again. It's like the world's biggest shrug emoji. or maybe it's just... Or maybe it's, you know, like a religious person raising his arms in exaltation to whatever deity they believe in. It's entirely possible that that's what the designers of the game had in mind, and they did that deliberately, putting it next to Emissary Kassar's pod. Grab the peeper so I can, gosh darn bone shark again. Yeah, I just wanted to grab that so I can, fuel the scanner room, although, in retrospect, I probably should have eaten it. Grab another one to eat. Did I get him? Yeah, I'm not good at this. Yeah, in some way, it's making it harder, because like when the stasis field is on them, it slows everything down. Anyway,
emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Make sure to right click to put it in the container. Don't left click to eat it.
Power restored. All primary systems online.
Okay, so yeah, so there's that data box. I think that's all to be found here. But I'm going to tell it to search for Rex anyway. And, so yeah, so I'm sure that, where is it now? Again, like, even when I'm looking for it, I have trouble finding it. So you can see the entry point going underground to that little area there. That is, that's directly south of this location. Going through my water faster this time around. Mind you, the previous session I had bulbo plants for a while, and then I had those blue bulb thingies for a while. Anyway, let's just, you know, for the heck of it, I just want to see if I can re-find that thing. Although I marked the location, right? Not the big skull one, but yeah. Underwater gate. Hold on. The underwater gate's over there. And what did I see that was south of us? Could it be there's another thing to be found here? Or am I just misjudging directions entirely? Yeah, and I keep, you know, I'm doing it again, like, I keep, I'm about to say a thing, and then I get distracted, and I forget to say it, but I was trying to, what's all this? It just goes up steeply there, doesn't it? But yeah, I was gonna make some comments about, like Kassar's religion. Because it seems to emphasize selfishness. maybe even nihilism. Like just from his parody of the Lord's Prayer, where he's talking about how he himself is the most important thing. And I think there were some comments from Paul Torgal about that too. So like, this is probably something that Paul Torgal is kind of contributed to him feeling really self-important. Okay, it's not looking nothing like what I thought I was looking for. Oh, whatever. Okay, I'm gonna have to go back to the scan room to reassess. But the wreck over there, that's the one that's in the tree that I already found, right? I mean, I know it is. I'm gonna look anyway, because I'd like to get visual confirmation. I mean, it's elevated. It's not like there's another wreck in the tree, probably. I wouldn't expect it anyway. The inability to gauge distances on these things is troubling. Like, it could be right in front of me and I wouldn't know it. And I mean, I don't, that's not even an exaggeration. It could be right in front of me. Like, because I have to wait for it to render. Like, I could be inside it for that matter. Yeah. So that's the same reckon. Even has my little Pathfinder nodes. I just want to confirm that the what's over here? Okay. Well, I'm gonna. You know what? I'm gonna look anyway. It's a linear path, so I'm not worried about getting lost.
Inside a long calcified root system. Evidence suggests it was eaten away by other life forms over many centuries to form these natural caves.
Oh, really? And there's a cuttlefish egg here. Huh. Well, I've already got another one of those back home. Like, it's the one egg that I didn't feed into the bioreactor. Okay, now this is interesting. This is, like, there's a cuttlefish egg, which are apparently, you know, life forms. Which,
welcome aboard, Captain.
Aren't native to the planet, or I think they might just be thrown in as an Easter egg, quite frankly, as a joke. This, it might be that there's all there is to it. That's that there's nothing else here, but I want to take a further look. I just like hit on this by random, pure random chance. I was not looking for this at all. Well, I mean, I was looking for anything, any unusual formations or whatever. But yeah, the scan room didn't help me find that. This is the base of the huge tree. Oh no, you don't. Yeah, you stay away. Okay, so it's in the base of the big tree, so it's so it isn't like a completely random, like impossible to find location. That's purple gel. Did that refact just vanish? Okay. Just checking. Okay. All right. So let's get back to the scanner room. There are more Cyclops pieces around. What kind of egg is that again? Oh, I think that's a bone shark egg, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, so I want to take a look at this again. It's hard. Like I want to, okay. Like I want to jump or crouch. Okay, I can jump. What I really want to do, I want to crouch. I want to freaking crouch. Is there an option? Okay, is there an option to crouch? That I've just, that's been here all along. And I just don't know. Here, you get to see my controls. Jump, hit, you can strike. Excellent. Left hand, right hand. Cycle next. Cycle previous. Slot 1 through 5. Tool alternate use. Take a picture. Reload. Sprint. Move up, down, forward, backward, left, right. Like if anything was going to crouch, I would think the move down button does, but it doesn't. Because I need that ability to, you know, 3D triangulate positions here. Because when I'm looking at it on a single plane, it's hard to gauge distances and directions. Okay, so maybe this entry point wasn't exactly south. That's why I didn't see it. Because right now, with respect to the giant tree, I'm facing like north by northwest. Well, a little, not quite north by northwest. It's a little, I don't know, north by northwest or something like that. It's a little west of northwest. So a little east of southeast, you know, a little east of south. I should be able to see it. I was going straight south, so it's a little east of south. Well, a little east of south from the position of the giant tree. So if I move over to the giant tree, and travel a little east of south, so this direction, I should find that cave. And that right there is the, jerk. Give me a chance to just look around and stuff, come on. Yeah, I think this is it here. and you follow this little gulf here. I don't know if gulf is the right word. It's this little chasm. Underwater gate. Oh. I was looking at the... Oh, yeah, it's really me. I was looking at the wrong, get the wrong beacon. But yeah, okay. So I want to just do something a little silly. Drop a piece of titanium here, which is going to seem like a strange thing to do, probably. But there's the madness in my method. Or wait, method to my madness, that's what I meant to say. And then I'm going to tell the scanner to scan for titanium, and if this is that cavern, it should detect the titanium in it. Theoretically. It might detect other titanium. I didn't even look to see if there was titanium in the list. I should probably bring like a few different rare elements along with me that don't normally get. Actually, I could just bring an ion cube. Probably gonna find a bunch of like big titanium things too. But yeah, if that cavern is this thing in the middle, then I should see the red dot appear here. That's my theory. Okay. There we go. So that's the confirmation that I found what I was looking for. Okay. What's it? What? There's another one? Why is there another one? Like, there's one right next to the underwater gate beacon that I placed there. But why? Like, seriously, where? There's another one which is apparently very close by. I guess that's it there. I'm guessing. Oh, right, the one that I dropped. That's funny. The one that went, oh, you have no room for it. Okay. Anyway, while I'm here, I think it really does take a while for it to become depowered. It's kind of cool. Anyway, like, it takes longer than I would expect a single fish to power it. There's lithium there. If you ever want more lithium, this is a good place to look, it seems. I keep seeing little bits of lithium around, and I notice them. Anyway. I'll turn around. This is the way, right? Oh no. Oh wow. If in that case, maybe I don't want to drop an ion cube here. Does titanium seriously sink through the floor? Yeah, and there's an alien gate here. Like, at first it's like, holy crap, found this big super secret here, but. Like, you can't do anything with it. Like, even now that I know that, yes, they are actually gateways that allow you to travel from one place to another. Like, there's no obvious way to activate this one. There's no non-obvious way to activate it. It's just, it's just there. It's just a, as it is, it's just a curiosity. Like, I don't know. Maybe if I carry an ion cube up to it, maybe the ion cube thingy will pop out. But that, like, that didn't happen. Like, the one back on the I'm running out of water. I'm gonna have to wrap this up soon. I mean, the one on the enforcement station island didn't need me to bring an ion cube to it in order for the thing to be there. Maybe I should try it anyway, just for the heck of it. Just carry an ion cube up to it, just to see what happens. I don't know.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Anyway, yeah, it's this has been a mostly fruitless journey. Like I got the blueprint for the Cyclops and, you know, thermal generator. So there's that. That's something, I guess. Whoa. When did I take that much damage? 62, what the heck? Like, I know the bone shark took a bite out of me there, but didn't realize that it had taken that much damage. Anyway.
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Let's take this all apart. And recover those range upgrades. And grab a bite to eat, maybe. Never actually used that. Oops. Didn't mean to put the power cell in there. That's my spare power cell in case need to recharge the thing, the Seamoth. Yeah, I'm at that point. I'm at that point where the hungriness is making it harder to concentrate. I should wrap up this recording. Like, what did I even find? What did I gain from this trip? I mean, I don't know. Like, yeah, I got the blueprint for the Cyclops upgrade, which is, I mean, could be nice if I decide to take the Cyclops down to that lava-filled place, but, you know, again, like I said before, I'll say it again, like, I just don't see the advantage of the Cyclops. Like, it's slow and ponderous and clunky, like, it's not very maneuverable. And it has no way to defend itself. Like, if a Leviathan decides to attack me while I'm in the Cyclops, I'm screwed. Like, I've got the shield upgrade now, which can which will allow it to hold up for a short time. Like, I mean, I don't know, conceivably maybe I could get the put the shield up and then hop in the prawn to punch out the Leviathan. But, like, you know, even that, like fighting Leviathan in the prawn takes time. Like, it's gonna come. It's like I'm gonna completely discharge before I can do anything. And it's just like, and again, like, what's the advantage? Like, what's the advantage of the Cyclops? What, they can go deeper? I mean, once it's upgraded, I guess it can go deeper than the sea moth. I haven't gotten any upgrades that go deeper than the prawn. And like, once you got that grappling arm and jump jet upgrade, the prawn is fairly mobile. I'd rather take it than the Cyclops, that's for sure. You know, given the choice, like there just aren't any circumstances where I'm like, oh, I wish I had the Cyclops here. You know, there's no circumstance where it's a clear advantage. Like the Seamoth is less armored or protected. Oh, this is what's going on here. Like it's less armored, less protected, but it's more maneuverable. If shit hits the fan, like I feel like I have a better chance of escaping in the Seamoth than the Cyclops. You know, like back in season two when I took the Cyclops out to use Pod and the Ghost Leviathan started attacking it, I was like, I was fortunate that Ghost Leviathan broke off the attack. Because he would have absolutely wrecked me. He would have. Oh, there's the crash fish pod there. But yeah, he would have absolutely wrecked the Cyclops if he continued attacking. And yeah, I was fortunate that he stopped attacking. So, yeah, like mostly useless. Yeah, it's just a big toy. It looks cool. You know, it feels cool the first time you're piloting it, and it's like, whoa, look at all these controls. But yeah, and the fact that it is so incredibly energy inefficient. You go a kilometer and a half and you used up a third of your total power, and you need two power cells to replace just that. Ooh, I'm not sorry to you, Biter. I'm so mean. You know, like, you can't get anywhere with it. Like, you can't... Yeah, I don't know, like, maybe there's something that I'm missing, but it just seems like I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan of the Cyclops. Yeah, the Cyclops thermal reactor module needs kyanite. That's a reminder. Yeah, pretty soon I'm gonna have to go deep into that lava-filled place. See about getting kyanite and stuff. Takes two polyaniline. Yeah, something I'm gonna have to do soon. Want to see if I can see if there's more stuff to be found here. I'd still like to plunk down some more what am I trying to say here? I'd like to plunk down some more scanner rooms and see what else I can see. Okay, so last thing I'm gonna do, I'm just looking over all these drones for all the scanner rooms that got abandoned. Considering my next moves, considering where I'm gonna put my next scanner rooms down, Might be neat to put it here, get an idea. I know the case system underneath is pretty extensive, and I think I've explored it pretty well, to be honest, but might still be interesting to put a scan room down there. You know, same with next to Keen's broadcast location. I'd deactivate that one because I already went there just now. I already went there. Yeah, and it might also be worth going to the codes and clues, the other like things like Life Pod 7, because that's where I found the Sea Treader Leviathans, and I kind of wonder if maybe I already kind of did try to go put a scanner room down there, because that's when I found the edge of the crater and the Ghost Leviathan almost died. Maybe this time I don't go quite so far out. It could be worth taking a look, at least getting the scanner's topographical scan, get an idea what the surrounding area is like. Could be worth a look. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, I think that's enough out of this for today. Really, what did I get? I accomplished? I got a blueprint that I don't care about. I found a little backstory on Bart Torgal, I guess. I want to feel like I accomplished something, and I don't feel like I accomplished a lot. But, oh well. I mean, just means maybe there's something more I'll discover next time. I don't know, the tree structure with the shrugging tree was kind of neat. Maybe I'll make that the thumbnail. Anyway, until next time.